So therefore, this and this should be together. All right. You see, I'm carefully putting it down. Though I can close my eyes and I'll still face this. But for you guys that have not done this before, I will be gentle with it. I'll do it carefully. You see this hook? I'm trying to hook it down to this. Take it down. Rotate until you find a particular bearing. Okay, you heard that sound. That is a sound to tell you they sit together, they are now in position. Hey guys, welcome to another interesting class. Hope you are having a good time going through our videos. However, if you have gone through our videos and you like our content, do well to subscribe and turn on notification bell, so when there's a new video, you are among the first to see them. You get. All right, on today's class, we'll be looking at how to fix a starter. This is a portable generator starter, aka I better pass my neighbor. That's what the gen is called. So this is the starter for the generator. So what we have here, the issue we have is that this cord has refused to return, like it pulled out and couldn't go back. Although I basically know what would be wrong with the starter, but for the purpose of this class, I will have to lose everything and explain deeply. You get. Okay, one of those things that could cause this, one of those things that could cause this issue, starter not returning, not going back to default setting after pull, is the spring. And for this particular class, I will be teaching in details how to fix the spring. Okay, when your spring is broken, your starter cord will never return. When your spring is bent, not in the required shape needed by the starter, your starter cord can never return. All right, without further ado, let's go into our class proper. Okay, there's a video on the tools you need for losing your generator starter. You can check the description below and you'll find the link to that video, or you can go through our other videos and you definitely find that video. So what happened to this cord now is this spring, over time, let me take it out. Over time, while taking off the spring, just be very careful because there's a way it will come out and it can cause bruises on your hands or your face, basically any part of your body close to it at that point in time. Okay, this spring, however, from the way it looks, has been in use for a very long time, and from the way it looks now, it's more likely I've exceeded its use. It's no longer valid. Do you know why I said so? If you call it back, you observe that this place, this particular point, let's call it back so you get what I'm saying. When you coil a starter back, you observe that, you should observe that this is supposed to go down by default setting. This particular point is going to, supposed to go down, but this one is at the top now. It has refused to go down. Basically, this thing can never be used again. Cannot be used. Although, I can technically put it back to position, but it's going to be difficult for first timers or for those not usually accustomed to fixing generators, and for that reason I'm going to change it all together. I will change the spring and I will use a new one. This new spring is gotten from our shop as well. You can check the link on the description box above below, specifically shop.bencoengineering.com, to see the stocks we have there. They are quite affordable as well and of good quality. All right, we have a new spring. This is a new spring, right? how do we fix this now? Okay, I wouldn't advise for first timers to take off this. Normally, I can take off this and I'll decide to rotate it myself. I wouldn't advise that for first timers. And that's where the tweak comes in. What do we do as first timers? If you locate this pan very well, I want to look at this pan very well. You'll see different points. 1, 2, 3, 4. This allows for this. When you put this here, it hooks. Then you just need to use your hand to arrange it better so it stays in position. Are you getting me? All right, let's do that. This is it. This is it. First thing, you must not allow this sleeve, this circumference. For any reason this goes out and you don't know how to fix a starter spring before now, you can't fix it. So you have to be careful and fix properly. So this is it. What have I done now? I've carefully put this into position, this hook into position, this spring hook into this position. Okay, what I do next is I press it down. So I take off this whole stuff, because if I take it out without pressing it down, it's more like I've done a useless job and it's not going to work. You see the force I use in picking it down. Okay, I've taken it out already. Are you seeing this? Good, I've taken it out. And then I let it arrange itself round. Are we good? It's quite simple, but it's equally technical. Okay, I've successfully removed the bad spring and I fixed a new one by not rotating it at all, by not wounding the spring around these points. Are you getting me? Alright, what do we do next? If you look at this particular rubber shape stuff, you will see there's a hook here as well. Okay, this is it. There's a hook here. I'm sorry, there was greasy and there's a hook here. See this hook? Okay, this hook should enter this point as well. So therefore, this and this should be together. Alright, you see, I'm carefully putting it down. Though I can close my eyes and I'll still fix this, but for you guys that have not done this before, I will be gentle with it. I'll do it carefully. You see this hook? I'm trying to hook it down to this. Take it down, rotate until you find a particular bearing. Okay, you hear that sound? That is a sound to tell you they sit together. They are now in position. Good. I will take this out gently. I just want my space to be nice. Okay, I've done that right. Just to be sure that the spring and this rubber are now perfectly together, I will rotate to the left. If I take it to the left, which is anti-clockwise, if I take it to the left and it returns back, that means we've successfully done a good job. You see? I take it to the left. See? That's anti-clockwise, this way. And it returns back. So we've done a good job. What do we do next? Take this pan. You see this point again? Lest I forget, this is the casher. They are not always together. This casher and this are not always together. Okay, but while I was taking them out, I did take it out carefully. So try your possible best to take it out carefully. But just in case you try taking it out carefully and somehow falls off, this is how we fix it back. This casher should be here. Okay? Alright. And this hook, there's a hook here again. There's a hook here again. You try to make this point lap with this point, meaning they should hook together. It's more like a boat. Most of the times, you just view this as a boat going through a knot. I don't know if that explanation should do, but just view it as a boat. This particular point, I'm not talking about this. This particular point going into a knot. So this is it. This place should hook this. Okay? Try your possible best to find it and just look at it from the side, because you can't get it from the top. Okay, it seems it has hooked now. I'm just trying to. Good. Most times you should know that when stuff like this hook, it just goes into position. You just see it go into position. You don't need to stress yourself. Okay. To be sure, this is it. I'm just going to take this somehow. See this? I'm just trying to turn it and you see the casher coming out. This is the same casher that hooks the flyway. See the casher coming out. This is it. Are you getting me? That shows this pan has been able to sit properly with this casher. All right, let's tighten. All right, what do we do next? We take this, we try to make this rope get to this point. My hand is so oily now and it can barely stick to any objects. The reason I can't really turn this place with my hand, I have to use the screwdriver. Okay, we've done this now. We take this to the left. Allow the rope to hook this. Take it to the left now, which is anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise. Turn it for about 3 times or 4. The more you turn it, the harder it becomes. You know it's a spring. And then you pull out the rope and let it go through on its own. You see how it returns now. See it? Good. We've done that and it has not gotten to, the rope has not entered fully. So what do we do next? You go back, take the rope, hook it back to this particular spot, which we did earlier, this particular spot, hook it back to it, then rotate anti-clockwise for another 2 to 3 times. That's one, this two. I'll do it at two. Let's see. You see it now? So we've successfully changed this bad spring that has been the fault of this the whole time and replaced it with a new one. If you've enjoyed this beautiful class, please do well to subscribe. Please turn on the notification bell. Send this link to friends and family so that they can watch these videos as well. And please do communicate with us via the comment section so that we can interact together. It's goodbye from my end till we meet in our next class.